We had a very short break. Now on stage is Reimer Bauer, and we will take a step up from using Turtle, now using fancy 3D software, teaching young people programming. Okay.
Reimer. Yeah, hello. We have a different approach. We also know Turtle, but our idea is that we want child to learn object-oriented programming at the beginning, not making hello world and not functions, just to start. And usually there's a problem if you make some objects, you can't see them, you have to tell these are objects, it's not visible and so on. And we had a different idea, and also to make this more attractive, we are making a contest always. We do this, have this done now 2 years. And yesterday there was a child, 13 years old, who made a 140-line Python program which runs, is, makes a movie and makes which makes some icicle drops and so on. And I'll show this later. The idea is just from this kind of having a contest to make it more valuable. And we got to this because we want that more schooler children can program. They have to learn this somehow, and they should not only be just be user or be programmed by everything which is around, and just by using this, they just should learn to program themselves. And this should be easy. And we found out that there are some interests from them, so you have to have maybe something with movements, you have to make music or something else, or images, and so that they are like this to do. And also if you go to a school and want to have teachers, it must be also for them very easy. And so you have to provide also course material. You can't tell just make Python and you have a book, this won't work. So you have to do something they like to use. And the project idea was also built by the PySV, and there's also Peter Koppertz who has the initial idea to make it with Blender. Because Blender, he said yesterday, it's a Trojan horse. If you install Blender, you have the modernst Python on your system. And this is the same Python installation on each platform. You have it on Mac, on Windows, and on Linux. And it's very easily just, you have one step to do, install Blender, and then you can work with Python 3.4. It's very simple. And it's also very well documented. There's an API for Python. And everything you can do with a mouse, there was yesterday a training, there were 70 attendees there. And everything you can make with a mouse, with clicks, buttons, you can do with Python. And the thing is, if you make in Blender, it's used to make also movies, you can handle these objects and you see them and they're in 3D and you can scale, rotate or whatever. And by this, just showing this, the telling about what an object is and what a method is so easily, and it's clear to understand. And so it's also easy to learn. We have in our course a lot of material already and also some parts for school from chemistry and mathematics, and we wish to have a bit more on this. If you want to see how a Python script looks like, it's quite similar as everywhere else. You have just a class definition or anything else. You have to do some imports, and this all is explained. Also, the IDE, there are always some discussions which IDE. Blender has its own scripting IDE. This is an example how clouds could be seen then. And in the area there, you can also may rotate them or make something look at them from a different point of view, and so also can change your code afterwards. And if you run the script, maybe it's a bit more extended, it looks like this, and this is just a few lines of code, if you know how this works. And this is the part you can learn. And also the to show that you have a complete Python terminal. You can just try import this or import anti-gravity. It behaves exactly the same as you have your own Python shell. Also, we did already some courses. At the first, in Florence last year, I announced the start of the first contest. And there was Jens Klein. Jens is right, but Klein is wrong. Who found this there, and he made the first course. And so it was first course in Wien, then we had in Cologne, in Berlin, Hamburg, and Leipzig courses for the this material we produced. And these are quite easy to make just 3D objects. You can make games or scenes. You can make movies. Everything you do there is, as a result, is a movie. And this is very interesting. So you can show very different your skills. And you can also present them in not only 2D graphics, just make them also 3D look like. And the contest task to this course is that you can your program manage just everything. You are not allowed to take any clicks of this IDE. You just write everything in Python. And if you were in the tutorial yesterday, I think you have seen that every click on the IDE shows you the Python command line. You just have to copy in your text window and then you can run it and don't have to click it again. And the contest is also that everything must be done by the Python program, and you have to submit the animation, the Python program, also the screencast. It's not so very difficult. So we had two results in last year, which were very good. And this was about just making an algorithm. I think lots of us are known with this. Conway's Game of Life, and also a game and simulation, and this year a simulation again. And I want to show you the results because that's more than just words. That's the first one from Anna Koine. She is 16 years old, and she thought she shows us how a Conway Game of Life can be done in 3D. So just all these combinations. And it's so I go to the next one. That's Valentin. He started with 13 years. And he did continue on this, and is very famous currently because he won the Kiwi contest this year, the International Kiwi contest. So he's very interesting in all this stuff. And if you find out some schooler students around and they like programming, maybe try one of the courses with them and maybe also tell them there may be a contest. They can just make movies. And this is a card game. In Germany, it's named Skat. You play it with three persons, and then you have to announce, I've disabled the sound. He also had the idea, he makes voice recordings of his family. And so that there are three different speakers tell the card numbers from different directions. The blender has also 3D sounds, so you can make very interesting special effects. So you can't believe there's someone winning here. And it's all done with Python, and he likes that it's randomized, that every game looks different. And he extended this that someone can play against the computer. Very simple. So if I remember what I did with 13, I wasn't able to do this. This is the winner from this year. He had the idea to make just a small project, which he names Eiszapfenhöhle, which is the meaning of icicle cave. It's just to see ice on top and then falling drops and then building new ice pickles. And this is then also with sound, so every release of a drop and every touchdown makes a new sound. And this is just 142 lines long, with comments, so even shorter. And so it's just an idea to start with this coarse material and just to try out. And this is just for completion. The idea is just to make it easily to learn and also have teaching courses. We have these currently in German. We have started to translate them in English, and we are interested in having a good English compatible course, maybe the base of further development of this. And you are all, if you like it, you are invited to join us at the sprints. We like to have a documentation sprint about this. And all this material is online available, and it has a license to copy it. Copy and use. It's a CC BY-SA license. And it's very easy, as you have seen. There, we have already Childs. They found out it's easy to learn. And also we have a Flask application, which is a web page for this Condes. It's a Flask and Jinja 2 based application. Yeah, I have said this already. We want you. We want to go international, maybe a contest like the one in German in your country, maybe not together at all the time. Just that you maybe find out, oh, it's interesting to do this in your country also. Maybe make something similar. We also want a good English translation of this. And yeah, maybe you extend it to make your own course. The school year students are very interested at the moment. They see what they can do with Blender. And you have to be careful that they give up to take everything with a mouse. But at the moment, they now, if you show them a movie, there are lots on the YouTube channel because there are also contests making movies. There is, for example, Big Bug Bunny and then some other more, and there are some scenes there that has to be built grass on the ground. And if you tell them, just make one grass, that's so easy, but then make it 10,000 times, then it's clear that they need a programming language. They don't want to paint this. Okay. So, and also, we want support. Maybe we have more ideas how to make chemistry, or we have some molecules already, or we have some mass functions to make special diagrams in 3D, which is also maybe interesting to get this together at school. The idea is also to get these different things together. If someone programs, there's a question for, if he has a physics experiment and he wants to show simulate this, it may be possible in Blender because there is a lot of physics inside. You can throw a ball, for example, and then it knows it must come to the Earth. So it, and it jumps back and not with full speed and to the same level. It knows this everything. And so it's easy to combine this also in school, also with some other things. And yeah. So for currently, our partners are small companies in Germany, which helps us, for example, to make it more popular, or to spread the word, or to show up at trainings, or help us with images and so on. Okay, so.
Okay, thank you. Very impressive and impressive results. Questions, maybe the first question for me, how do you reach out to people? Do you go directly to schools? How do you get into contact with teenagers or children? Do you go to public schools, or is it mouse-to-mouse propaganda? Or?
We used to have summer courses. We did summer courses, and also we were on Linux Tag in Chemnitz and Berlin and so on, and we give there also courses. We try to go there where all the interesting scholar styles are. There are some camps already. We are also looking to go forward to go with the German institution, the VDI, together. So that they can share their more knowledge. The problem is, if you show, oh, we have a course and something, you can't expect that their scholar students come. They don't know what this is. And so it's easy if you have some positions in some institutes, for example, also where so you have visitors from schools there regularly. They have to visit because of job research. They want to know what they maybe want to become later in job, what they should study and so on. Then they visit some institute. And at this time, if you have at the right time the course, so you can also grab all these people and tell them something very important that they need in the future. They have to learn programming. So, but it's a difficult problem.
Okay, more feedback, more questions?
The Blender UI has a reputation for being difficult to use at first and taking a long time to become familiar with the UI and make models and stuff. How much of the time, as you were teaching these kids Blender, how much of the time was spent just learning to use Blender as opposed to programming in Python?
I think it's much easier to show a little bit. If you want to learn Blender with Python, you have to install it. Maybe this takes 2 minutes. You have to download it, install it, and get it somewhere. Then it looks like this. And then in the newer versions, they have seen that there are a lot of programmers and they want it easier. So they implemented something, they named it scripting. And at this moment, you have an IDE, and you also can just I should have prepared this. That's not so easy. You could open a script there and run it. And also you could type something here or use a terminal. And what we explain at the trainings for them, how to use some buttons, the A button, so that selects everything, and then the delete button, that they can get rid of this. And so it's only 1 hour in total. There are only a few parts always, and we start concentrating on Python. And what happens if they, for example, if you scroll this down, and if I do something here, you see there's a Python command. And this is very good because there's something also more. If you have to look for something. So if you're on this side, then also have now a different problem with my screen resolution. So, but here I can show it. At the moment, if you click the right mouse button on one of these menus, you get the API documentation of Blender. And you can see, there's online Python reference. This is with every command you can do in Blender. And if you go on this, then your browser opens and you are shown how to use this. And this is also part, it's in English. So the students have to acknowledge that they have to learn English, understand English in school, which is also for German students good. And also, if they want to do in Blender something, they learn something more, that math is maybe also something they should keep on, because otherwise they have to, if they want now the triangle has 180 degrees, if they know this, then they can build a lot of things very easily. And to the course material, this is the web page of the contest. And also, I try to show an example. So, yeah, as you see, this is in German, unfortunately. And in the Blender tutorial is something which makes a bottle. I'm not. Who of you were in the Blender tutorial? Oh, no one. Good. Then.
I'm just interrupting you. How far are you with the English translation? He wanted to get part of the contest this year, but everything is in German, so. It was really, really difficult for him to follow. He starts speaking English, German maybe next year, a little bit. But so far, even with Google Translator, it was not an efficient material, cost material. So this is just a real problem for non-German speakers.
Yes.
So how can we help, or how can we work for you if there's only German available as a language?
We have it since a few days on Transiflex, which is a translation service. And so there can be pages added, changed. And we are at the beginning. It's maybe translated a bit, but not in good English state. That's so. And if we could start and make maybe 30% to 40% maybe, then it's much easier to find others also to get, and usually a sprint is a good idea to start with such a project. There are usually much speakers there which can English and German, and so I hope we get to this close.
Okay, that's it. Thank you again, Reimer.